Good afternoon. Welcome to Holt International Business School's commencement ceremony for the class of 2022. My name is Rachel Boyce. On behalf of the faculty and staff, we're excited to have you here today on this joyous occasion. Before we begin, we have a few reminders. We ask that all guests remain seated in the theater for the entire ceremony. A photographer is on site taking photos of today's events. Please put your cell phone on silent and turn off the flash. If you need to take a phone call, we ask that you step into the lobby. Finally, if you feel unwell at any time, please step outside. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand in order to recognize the graduating class of 2022. Please remain standing as we welcome the distinguished Holt faculty and academic staff. Ceremony to Dean Ted Ladd.
Fellow members of the faculty, family, friends, current students, and graduating students, please be seated. Good afternoon. My name is Ted Ladd. I am the Dean of the San Francisco campus of the Holt International Business School. It is my pleasure to guide us through this momentous occasion. This week, Holt will hold graduation ceremonies in Boston, San Francisco, London, and Dubai. Collectively, your class represents 110 nationalities and speaks 100 different languages. This is indeed a global event. In addition to connecting each of us to each other, graduation exercises are also occasions to convey wisdom to our graduating students. Indeed, I carefully chose two speakers specifically for their ability to offer wisdom that challenges the intellect, inspires the spirit, and rouses the conscience on this auspicious occasion. I can think of nobody better to do this than our Holt alumni speaker today, Katie Callens. Katie graduated, Katie graduated from Holt San Francisco with an MBA in 2017 and served as president of Holt's Net Impact chapter. Today, Katie works at Meta, the parent company of Facebook, as a senior sustainability manager, leading their internal engagement and communication program, as well as chairing Meta's Sustainability Council and half a dozen other climate-focused working groups. Before joining Meta, Katie led businesses through sustainable strategy transformations through consulting at BSR, which stands for Business for Social Responsibility, and through corporate citizenship. Before Holt, she spent 4 years building Google's sustainable design and construction program across their global real estate portfolio, and worked in water policy at EPA headquarters in Washington, D.C. join me in welcoming Katie Callens.
Good afternoon, HALT graduates. When Ted asked me to speak today, I was honored and excited to share my journey leveraging business to accelerate climate action and build resilient communities. I was also happy to know that accounting grades were not highly weighted in the speaker nomination process. The most successful companies in the world are using the climate lens to drive strategy decisions and returns on the triple bottom line: people, profit, and planet. But it's not easy for most organizations to do so effectively. And in the last 4 years, I've been building a community of climate advocates across Meta. I launched our first sustainability council and now oversee working groups driving sustainability, ESG, circularity, and climate product work across the company. I also lead our internal engagement and communications program. So why is aligning Meta's business strategy and culture to sustainability necessary to reach our audacious goal of net zero greenhouse gas emissions by 2030? Because my team of 30 serves a company of 80,000. We'll only reach net zero through partnering with every executive across every region to drive down emissions across our value chain, support nature-based climate solutions, and build climate tools on our platform. Every job is a climate job. I came to corporate sustainability after researching water policy in Washington State and Melbourne, Australia, and starting my career at the Environmental Protection Agency, where it became clear that the climate crisis was a society-level problem that needed a multi-sector solution. Action needed to move faster than policy, and I saw that the business world could use more nimble levers of change, so I joined Google's Green Building team. For a company obsessed with organizing the world's information, I was shocked by how little they knew about the chemical ingredients in their office chairs and ceiling tiles. My work helped push an industry leader towards transparency and disclosure in the name of human health and ecological sustainability. At Google, I also got a taste for global business and how international actors could drive the climate movement forward across diverse cultures and industries. But I wanted a deeper understanding. The climate crisis was already disrupting and reshaping global business, and I wanted to drive that energy toward positive impact. I applied to HALT for my MBA. From private insurance companies in France developing new products to fend off catastrophic wildfires, to a textile factory in Bangkok transitioning away from cotton towards cheaper bamboo that also uses less water and pesticides to produce, to drone companies partnering with indigenous tribes in Brazil to monitor deforestation efforts in the Amazon, the shifting landscape of business and climate are intricately linked and dependent on each other. While studying at HALT's international campuses, I saw these examples firsthand. While flying into Shanghai, China, I saw endless fields of solar panels. But upon arrival, pollution shrouded the sky. Rapid decarbonization was neither enjoyable nor equitable. While finishing my degree in London, the city was reeling from Brexit, and anxious soon-to-be graduates were researching where else in the EU they could settle in the light of turbulent economic times. I was struck by how vital global cooperation was for long-term climate action, and how the UK leaving the European Union was thrashing both the regional economy as well as mutually supportive climate goals. When I returned home 5 years ago, to sit in those same chairs that you're sitting in today and ponder my next career move, my home state of California was already deep in the largest drought in 1,200 years. The coastal forests that had inspired me to study water policy were fueling new wildfire records. At HALT, I learned the value of growth mindset and the power of cross-cultural communications, two skills I now use every day at Meta. Because pitching a sustainability initiative to a finance team in New York and then a policy team in Dublin is actually quite similar to pitching a project plan to your Swedish classmate and then getting your Brazilian colleague to show up to a meeting on time. I joke, but knowing your audience and how to move them is just as important in sustainability and climate as any other role in business. Will this executive be swayed by impressive data tables or a persuasive narrative? Despite the urgency of the climate crisis, change in large organizations happens slowly. And even after a decade of this work, I can still get disheartened. But as a dear colleague once advised me, always hear no as not yet. HALT graduates, your skills and expertise are more lucrative to the climate movement than you know. Because while I may be a sustainability expert, do you know what I am not? I am not a marketing whiz or a supply chain lead or a marketing executive, but you are. Your superpowers in the business world mean that you can see climate opportunities where others simply cannot, which creates boundless opportunities for change. Every job is a climate job. Business action on climate is principal to our collective success, and you are in a position to take action. I look forward to working alongside you. Thank you.
Thank you, Katie. That was a vital reminder of the obligations we have as business professionals and as citizens of the world. Our keynote speaker today, Liz Klima, has spent her career formulating and operationalizing breakthrough strategies for some of the world's leading corporations and nonprofit organizations. Liz served 10 years in leadership roles in the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. Based in New Delhi as India Country Director for Health, she led the integration of programming of $450 million in investment to support India's achievement of UN Sustainable Development Goals. As CFO for the Foundation's Global Health Division, she directed strategic and financial planning for deployment of $1.2 billion in annual charitable investments to combat infectious diseases disproportionately affecting the developing world. Previously, Liz was a principal at Bain & Company, where she specialized in corporate transformation, advising multinational clients in the U.S. and Europe on strategy, operations, organization, and M&A. Prior to Bain, Liz focused on private sector development in Russia and the former Soviet Union, both as an independent consultant and with the International Finance Corporation, where she led the technical assistance and advisory services teams for financial markets across the former USSR. Liz holds an MBA in finance from the Wharton School, an MA in Russian Area Studies and International Economics from the Johns Hopkins School of Advanced International Studies, and a BA in Social Studies from Harvard University. Please join me in welcoming Liz Klima.
Well, I think the first thing I have to say is congratulations to the HALT class of 2022. And I have to say congratulations with gratitude to the family and friends that have supported you all through this major accomplishment. I think they deserve a round of applause too. I want to thank Dean Ladd for giving me the honor of joining in this esteemed celebration with you today, and for assuming I have some wisdom to bestow, to add to the rich lessons that your HALT professors and advisors and classmates have given you as you start this new chapter of life. So looking for the best advice and inspiration that I could find for this address, I reached out to my own classmates of Wharton Business School 1998, and I asked, what piece of advice do you wish someone had given us at business school graduation? I got some doozies back. Among those responses were, Remember to remove the dry cleaning tag from your suit before your Goldman Sachs interview. That one really smarted me because I actually made that mistake. Have the courage to not compare yourself to other people. Take risks, commit, be decisive. The road of life is paved with flat squirrels that couldn't make decisions. And not to spoil the ending, but everything is going to be okay. This last tidbit really resonates with me. I mean, let's face it, today is a full spectrum emotional experience for grads and their families. There's relief, pride, elation, excitement, anxiety, maybe a little terror. Whether or not you've landed your dream job, you're wondering, have I made the right choices? The answer, to quote comedian Ed Helms, so long as your desire to explore exceeds your desire to not screw up, you're on the right track. In this spirit, I offer you two pieces of advice today. One, take the zigzag path. And two, nurture a beginner's mind. My curiosity, not well-laid plans, has fueled my career and my happiness. I'm an enthusiastic practitioner and advocate of what I call the zigzag career. A career that follows a nonlinear path, but a path that's not meandering. It's guided by curiosity and courage to stretch, and it's propelled by a strong back foot on which to pivot and push off. What do I mean by that? I used to play lacrosse. First home was my position, the closest defender to the opponent's goal, and my job was to score goals in the crowded mayhem of defense that surrounds the goal. A great first home is not the fastest or strongest offender on the field, but the one who can change direction on a dime. To get open for the pass, I'd plant my foot, pivot, and push off. To pivot your career, you must target what you want to learn in the present chapter that will ground that back foot to push off and change direction in the next chapter. I've followed a zigzag career not because I'm indecisive, but because I'm always looking for novel ways to combine knowledge and skills. I've shifted repeatedly between for-profit and social sectors, between developed and developing economies. And at each pivot, I pushed off that strong back foot, that learning from the prior experience. So my zigzag path looks something like this. I entered graduate school targeting a career in economic development, specifically in transition economies of the former Soviet Union. I had visions of joining the World Bank or a regional development bank. But in my final year, my mentors from those institutions told me to go back to the private sector and learn skills necessary for the senior level jobs. That was zig number one. So I joined Bain & Company in Moscow. Unfortunately, on the eve of the Russian sovereign debt default, which meant that overnight, Russia was bankrupt and Bain's Moscow office closed. Big zag. I thought, how am I going to use this fresh MBA career chapter to do something relevant to my ambitions in economic development? I landed with Bain in London and focused my casework on big, sick corporate transformations. I decided I want to work on the hardest business problems with the most demanding clients to build what I thought was a skill set relevant to international development. When a few years later, Russia's economy was coming back, I decided to test this professional development strategy. This was a big, scary zag. I stepped off a fast-track to Bain Partner to take a three-year leave of absence to work for the World Bank Group, the IFC. That experience did confirm for me that the corporate skills I was developing were valuable in economic development, and it filled in a lot of gaps for me as an economist. I also learned what I needed to learn that I couldn't learn at the IFC. It was time to zag again. So back to Bain to mature as a leader. Then in 2010, I took another big zig. But very unexpectedly, not back to Russia. I got a call from the newly appointed HIV director at the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. Steph Bertozzi is a bit of a celebrity in the global health field, if you know it. He just accepted the mandate from Bill and Melinda to formulate the foundation's first ever strategy to reduce global deaths from HIV. Would I be interested to come on board to help? To be honest, my first response was, you have the wrong number. I don't know anything about public health. I never even had a healthcare client at Bain. All I know about HIV is you can't catch it from a toilet seat. And Steph's response to me was, that's kind of the point. I'm up to my eyeballs in MDs and PhDs, and I need someone who can think strategy. I thought, strategy I can do. I honed that at Bain. International aid and programming, I know. I learned that at IFC. I also thought, Bill and Melinda have launched history's largest ever philanthropic endeavor with audacious goals to eradicate diseases of the poor. The Gates Foundation isn't an organization, it's an historical event. Hell yeah, I want to be part of making history. So I joined. It was exciting and terrifying to leap in and work alongside the most brilliant minds in global health. To produce a strategy for Bill and Melinda's personal approval to spend over $1 billion of their money over the next 5 years. If that doesn't give you a moment of, what have I signed up for? I don't know what does. I was working with program officers with pages of publications and awards behind their names, with senior scientists, academicians, policymakers, activists, civil servants. How was I going to add value to this brain trust? 4 months later, we presented an HIV strategy to Bill and Melinda with rave reviews. My contribution? A beginner's mind. My success over the next 11 years at the Gates Foundation relied on the quality that produced successes on my client cases at Bain and at the IFC. A key success factor in the zigzag career, a beginner's mind. The beginner's mind describes an attitude of openness, an approach to situations devoid of preconceptions and judgment, as if you're seeing the situation for the first time. When you suspend preconceptions and judgments, you see new possibilities. The Japanese Zen Buddhist master Suzuki wrote, "In the beginner's mind, there are many possibilities, but in the expert's mind, there are few." A beginner's mind is receptive, curious, empathetic, humble, and therefore resilient. A beginner's mind gives rise to innovation, to breakthrough thinking. You're all familiar with the growth mindset? They still teach that in business school, I'm sure. Like growth mindset, a beginner's mind embraces malleability. it also brings a big dose of humility. It takes expectations and ego out of the equation. So, does this mean you don't need experts and technical expertise to formulate a strategy to combat HIV? Of course not. Very clearly, of course not. The HIV epidemic is a complex scientific, medical, governance, cultural, economic, social problem. You need experts. But precisely because it's such a complex problem, no single expert or discipline or domain has the solution. The Gates Foundation's business is to solve the world's most intractable problems. And that's only done through the intersection and integration of vast, diverse expertise and evidence. That's where you'll find the breakthrough solutions. That explains the crazy melting pot that is the staff of the Gates Foundation, trust me. It also explains the value of a person who questions established paradigms, makes explicit underlying logic and assumptions, bridges siloed thinking, probes the boundaries of evidence, who translates, integrates, and facilitates interdisciplinary problem solving. I ask a lot of questions. It's kind of my specialty. I recommend learning the art of asking questions. As long as we're here just to debunk one myth, there are stupid questions. But there are so many smart questions that go unanswered in your collaborations and your teams and your meetings, I'm sure. Why are we so confident that we have the right answer? What would have to be true for us to be wrong? Who would disagree with our conclusions and why? Ask yourself, what question would you ask if you were approaching the expert, the proposal, the prevailing logic, the well-entrenched way of doing things with a beginner's mind? In 2016, Gates Foundation leadership asked me to move to India for 3 years to lead our health team to produce an integrated health strategy. The grant portfolio had grown to about $450 million that spanned 20 different program areas, from tuberculosis to maternal health to health system strengthening and beyond. Our program officers and grantees on the ground are among the most experienced, respected professionals in Indian public health. And their investments were producing positive results. That's great news. The problem? No one could explain how it all fit together to maximize India's odds of achieving UN Sustainable Development Goals by 2030. All our program officers and grantees were working through the same public health system, serving the same communities, yet we couldn't point to the synergies or the relative priorities in our programming. Hence the need for an integrated health strategy. I was an American woman. I had no India-specific expertise. I was parachuted in from headquarters. Let's face it, any smart betting person would have predicted I'd get chewed up and spat out. But I didn't get spat out. Quite the opposite. From what was a fragmented team and a fragmented portfolio, we built an integrated health team that created a robust shared strategy. How? I didn't land with preconceptions about what needed to change. And I didn't land with a 90% baked strategy. I landed with a lot of questions. What precisely are our goals? And what's the gap to goal? What are we doing to bridge the gap? And what's the evidence telling us works and doesn't work? What are we learning? Why us? What's our comparative advantage in this space? My questions produced a common body of evidence and a common dialogue on which every team member could engage, raucously debate, but then finally agree and commit. When a leader asks questions, not only does it surface logic, assumptions, and evidence for the team to collectively ponder, but it also signals a vulnerability, which gives other team members the intellectual courage to question their boss and their peers and themselves. And that's how you co-create strategy and build a cohesive team. So, my advice to you as you cross this milestone into your career is to nurture a beginner's mind. Bring openness, curiosity, courage, humility. Ask great questions and really listen to people's answers. Great leaders do this. You're all future leaders by virtue of what earned you a seat at Hult and your credentials today. I wish you much professional success, and more importantly, much growth and happiness as you zig and zag your way through this next chapter of your lives. Thank you.
Thank you, Liz Klemma. You have inspired me for 25 years since we were roommates in graduate school. You continue to inspire me. Now it's my turn. Please prepare yourself for Dean Ted Ladd's spectacular graduation speech that concentrates all of my wisdom into a single nugget for the graduates of the Hult International Business School of San Francisco. Let me turn to my speech in the book. Where is it? This is embarrassing. Sandy?
Yeah?
Do you have my speech?
No.
Okay. I'm very sorry, but I think I have lost my speech. I think I left it on my desk back at campus. So if you'll bear with me, this would just take a few minutes. Could you just wait here? I will grab my phone. You can follow me as I rush back to campus. I'll use FaceTime. I'll be back in a second. Just wait. Pause for a second. Oh, no. That is premature. We're going to pause for a second. The tech team here is going to work their magic because I want you to see and hear the wisdom that I have attempted to collect for you today. This is indeed a series of Uncle Ted's war stories. Tech team, you tell me when you're ready. You're ready? Okay, let's do this again. I'm going to go back to campus. I'll be back in a second.
And you told me you were leaving. Put me down for a while, yeah. You knew I could have been leaving. Put a crap in my style, yeah.
Olaf, I lost my speech. Please, please help.
If you want to have a good future, you need to see the early signposts of change, shape them, and build the future that you want to see happen. For that is the way to prosperity and happiness.
I've seen Sam in the movies. He seems like an incredibly nice, funny guy. Sam, you got any advice?
Hey, Dean Ted. Oh, you lost your speech. Yeah, sure. I can just, like, off the top of my head, I can think of some things. I guess maybe you want to tell the graduates to, you know, use humor more often. You know, like sometimes, like, you know, only a pause, like an eye roll. Can, you know, are good enough to build like a human connection. So, I mean, I hope that helps. Does that help? Okay. Yeah. All right, I'll talk to you later. Yeah, call me anytime. All right. Bye.
Anka, no speech. What do you got?
It's important to do good to others while doing great to yourself. Please take care of people and planet.
Who else? Gina Torres was in The Matrix and Serenity and Suits. She's gotta have some good advice too.
Hey, Dean Ted. How are you? I got a message from you. I got a bit of a crazed message from you. You lost your speech, the one that you were gonna give to the graduates at Hult in San Francisco. Did you check all your pockets and your drawers and maybe left it in the car? Wish them health. Wish them strength, wish them love and adventures, and remind them to find the magic in every day. You think you got that? All right, I'm sure you'll find your script. I'm sure, well, speech. I'm sure you'll find it. They'll be fine. They've had you. Congratulations.
Carrie, I lost my speech. You're an expert at this. What should I do instead?
I hope you'll take with you the two questions that have served me well in my career. What if and why not? Those are the questions that are at the heart of innovation and disruption, and I hope you'll be willing to use them when you step into those moments of leadership.
Brian Cox was an actor in that TV show called Succession, which is all about money. Maybe Mr. Cox can give me some advice.
Hi, Dean Ted. Please tell graduates to act with courage, conviction, and even if they don't feel it, to form the world in the way they want.
Omar, I need some help. I lost my speech.
Our students from San Francisco should know how proud we are about your journey. Everything that you have achieved in the last 12 months that put you in this great position as change makers of this world.
Do you have advice for what I should say to these graduates?
My advice for you today is to hold on to those skills that you learned when you built the teams Those soft skills will really help you grow in your career.
Matt Lilly, you're the president of HALT. You must have some good advice for my speech.
Hey, Ted. Two bits of advice for you today. First of all, make sure you iron your shirt. Second, right before you go on stage, check your teeth for food. You got this.
Thomas, remember about 1355 Sansom Street, about a place that was home for at least a year for you. And whenever you're in the neighborhood, just swing by and say hi.
Mom, can you help?
Oh, Ted, I'm so sorry you did that. But I'm still proud of you, and I'm proud of your sister, and I'm proud of those students who've been at it for so many years, and congratulations to them and good luck. And Ted, don't do it again.
What should I turn to? How about the governor of California? Governor Newsom? Mrs. Newsom?
His higher education system is world class. Mm-hmm. And as a graduate, by definition, you are on a path to success. The opportunities ahead of you are, well, they're immeasurable. And with this education, we hope you can, well, help shape the future for better.
You're a great professor. You're very analytical. I lost my speech. Don't yell at me right now. What should I say?
You have the drive, the energy, the skills, and now the network to do whatever you want to do in your career. I'll share something that's always served me well, and that is, do what you love, and you'll never work a day in your life.
Laura, as my wife, you know me best. What should I say to these graduates?
Oh, Teddy, tell them how much you love them. For every ounce of your heart that you have put towards this past year, the students, the staff, every person on the HALT campus has reflected back tenfold what you've put in with their own spirit, their own love, their own passion. This is such a celebration of that shared love and community that you have created together today. Don't forget to tell them you love them.
I was not able to find my speech. So all I can say is congratulations to the class of 2022. Let's now shift our focus from people on stage to people in the audience, starting with recognition for our student leaders and ambassadors. Would the elected leaders of the HALT Student Association please rise and stay standing? There are many, stay standing. Please rise and stay standing. Rise and stay standing. There are many different forms of leadership. Rise and stay standing. You got all that? My favorite is called servant leadership, where the guiding principle is not to dictate, but to convene. Not to drive, but to generate community. This is exactly what you have done. Please join me in thanking the members of the HSA. Stay standing. Stay standing. Would all the club leaders please rise and stay standing? You have added adventures to our year outside of the classroom. Please join me in appreciating their efforts. Club leaders, please stay standing. Would our global ambassadors please rise? You show the world and remind us that we bring strengths and ideas from around the globe into a single place. All of us, please join me in applauding the energy, commitment, and impact to our community from these standing students. You may be seated. There are about 500 people in this auditorium who are not graduating today. They are here to celebrate you. Right now, right here, I would like you, the graduates, to celebrate them with a standing, stomping, cheering, hooting ovation. Stand up, turn around, and start yelling and stomping and hooting, please. Thank you. Please be seated. On behalf of the graduates, students, and faculty, I would like to thank and acknowledge the HALT staff. We are more than a team. We are a tribe of people who see and trust each other. We can bring our best selves to you, the students, and to you, the faculty, because our tribe encourages and applauds our best selves for and with each other. As my wife said, I do indeed love you all. Would members of the HALT staff all around this auditorium please stand up to be recognized? Thank you. You may be seated. The cohesion and authenticity of our tribe has been my greatest success as dean for the last 2 years. However, every professor should have an experience as an administrator to understand how the program functions, and every professor should then return to teaching and researching. Today's ceremony is my last official act as dean. Yeah. That's the faculty who are clapping. Yes. I will see next year's HALT MBAs, and I will see the dual degrees for Masters of Entrepreneurship and Innovation in classrooms on campus this fall. For those of you continuing on to dual degrees, please allow me to introduce the next dean of San Francisco, Barbara Godoy. She is experienced, process-oriented, and funny. Congratulations, Dean Godoy. All right, we will now move on to the distribution of degrees. Yes. Before we welcome the more than 200 students in this room to cross the stage, please allow me to recognize and congratulate the students who are also graduating today from this campus, but who could not attend in person. I'm looking at you right now on the camera. For students here in the auditorium, I will call you to the stage one program at a time. Here is the order of distribution of diplomas. I am giving you this information not as an invitation to leave, but instead just in case you really need to visit the restroom. MBAs, MIBs, MBANs, Masters of Finance, Masters of International Marketing, and then MDIs, okay? Before you walk across the stage, a representative from your program will say a few words. The official conferral of your degree will take place after all students from all programs have been called to the stage. A quick side note of trivia. On the tassel on your cap. All master's students should already have your tassel on the left. You only move the tassel when you are graduating from your undergraduate college. Thereafter, it always stays on the left. We begin today with our Masters of Business Administration program. Please join me in welcoming the class speaker, Michael Chen.
Thank you, Dean Ted, and welcome to all friends, family, and of course, Holt graduates. How are we feeling? Woo! Oh, that was weak. Let's do it one more time. How are you guys feeling? That's much better. Thank you. Now, I want to start off by asking just a few questions. I know, like our guest speaker said, asking good questions, right? So I have a question for you all, and this includes all the parents and everyone online as well. I want you to raise your hand if you ever felt proud of accomplishing something great, something successful. Anyone successful? Yeah, we did it. There we go. Now, I want you to take a moment and also reflect on the fact of maybe something you've done, maybe you've been rejected or failed upon. Anyone rejected, failure? Yeah. Oh, don't be shy. I see a couple of people didn't put their hands up. I see you. Now, I'm gonna take a moment to really think about a moment in time in my life where rejection really led me to something beautiful, speaking at this stage right now. As you think, I'm gonna tell a story. Before Holt, my teaching experience in Thailand for 3 years fueled my passion to commit to a career in education. Last year, I applied to my dream education program, and then when decisions were finally sent out, of course, I knew it. It was a rejection. It didn't feel right. When you have a dream, though, that is manifested over multiple years, that's crushed in a single moment in time, the only thing that goes through your entire body is hopelessness, despair, and a lot of pain. I did everything right, too. I attended every information session that they offered. They went above and beyond to obtain all the necessary experiences to stand out. I networked with the right individuals, gathered feedback, and prepared multiple iterations of essays, multiple, and still, of course, rejection. Despite feeling as lost as I did, I knew that this was not going to define me. And so I picked myself back up and started discovering other paths I could consider. I talked to my parents, friends, gym buddies, farmers at the farmer's market, fellow marathon runners, and even a few Hinge and Bumble dates as well. What I've realized is that business is an avenue to tackle my passion on environmental sustainability, and there's no better place to discover that than at Holt. My newfound passion is to commit a career to making this planet Earth better than I will leave it. I look back at that moment of time of rejection just a year ago and realize that it redirected me to where I'm standing right now. I'm confident that my experience is not unique, but when you're in it, you feel like you're the only one drowning while success seems like a distant and far fate. But take a look at us right now. You all have achieved such a tremendous accomplishment. Graduating with a master's, just think about that, with a master's from Holt. That is incredible. This moment is to celebrate the failures that you've endured and led you right here. Let's also celebrate your perseverance, grit, and determination for getting through a year intensive program. Every moment that we've shared together, the laughter in the hallways, the awkward moments of accidentally missing attendance while sitting in class, the stress of cramming 60 finance formulas on a single sheet of paper, the awkward feeling of being kicked out of a study room or being the one doing the kicking out, the Starbucks coffee chugging sessions with Dean Ted across the way, the many long study nights, the many WhatsApp memes sent during class, which I did not participate, I promise, professors, okay? And ultimately, each other's passion, culture, and passion. There's nowhere else in the world where you'll be part of such a diverse community, and hope that when you walk across this stage today, you don't just walk across with a diploma, but with a wealth of knowledge, cultural insights, and relationships, of course. At the end of the day, no matter what job you may have, how much you're making, or how many bitcoins you have in your crypto wallet, it's the people in your life that make it worthwhile. So keep your special people close and make sure to make time for those lunches and coffee chats. You never know what they're going to offer you. I'm elated for each and every one of you and the impact you'll make on the world. I also want to take a moment to thank the people who have helped me at my lowest lows and highest highs. My parents, my friends, my professors, my girlfriend, which, yes, one of those dates did work out. My roommate, my students in Thailand, and of course, my fellow students for supporting me unconditionally throughout my entire life and this journey at Holt. I really, truly couldn't do it without you. And if I leave you with anything, if you've just been texting the whole time I've been talking, I want you to leave you with this. The successes you have achieved are nothing but the sum of your failures. So be open to the failures and let those guide you to your next great success. Oh, and one final thing. Gracias, merci, shukriya, sheshe, doje, grazie, salamat, spasiba, efharetso, takskal duhal, arigato gozaimasu, kamsahamnidad, danke, danke, kapkun krap, dek ku yetsi, jazin tu parte, va lavam, and of course, thank you and best of luck.
Thank you, Michael. In every program, students vote for the professor who most impacted their student experience. Please help me recognize the MBA Professor of the Year, Dr. Olaf Grote. Olaf, please stand. Esteemed members of the faculty, I hereby present to you the graduating class of the Masters of Business Administration. Each student will walk on stage and receive a certificate commemorating the event. Students graduating with distinction, as represented by the gold cords worn around their necks, will walk first. There is a photographer here to snap your picture when I hand you their certificate and shake your hand. I now request Tracy Fitzgerald to please join me at the side podium and Vivian Manning to the certification table. Students, once you receive your certificate, please return directly to your seat. Please do not go to the balcony. All right. Should we do this?
Michael David Chen. Anirushi Dhawan. Carolina Geres Mosul. Evelyn Enibedi. Emanuele Doria. Francisco Javier Tamayo Chacon. Gabriele Atrocchi. Haotian Chu. Jeffrey Gartner. Katarina Juric. Leah Craig. Jennifer Bohan. Li Fei Shang. Olivier Bagou. Roberta Musso. Sarah Carol Aymur. Snehal Mohite. Isabel Pascual. Ayod Rishab Jain. Alex Aguilar. Ana Isabel Gordillo Arguello. Annie Jacqueline Salazar Camacho. Joe Kim. Carmen Ophelie Dasas Orega. Chera Ghosh. Ebunuola Olamatirun Ajumo. Georgios Geropoulos. Harvey Elijah Xanthos. Hisu Kim. Humphrey Oseji Abufokan. Jacqueline Escobar Albarracin. Jun Jiang. Catherine Ayala Dillon. Marie Berget. Masanao Kobayashi. Matija Pavicevic. Melissa Juliana Cardoso Collantes. Miguel Antonio Gizon Tioseco. Nelson Chekwube Mokulu. Nicholas Blackburn. Octavio Torres. Olaide Olurante Oyeyemi. Ola Tomiwa Adebiao Oduwo. Pamika Horsenchai. Pascal Chinonzo Oharzukre. Pernil Gardien. Priyanka Saini. Pulkit Argawal. Ruslan Adikonov. Shubham Rajendra Lagad. Siddharth Kotari. Tenglong Gu. And the best for last, Valentine Ifanyi Ogudo.
That has got to be the coolest part of my year. Our next program is the Masters of International Business. Please join me in welcoming class speaker Jessica Krentz.
Thank you, Dean Ted. Dear graduates, families, friends, HALT staff, and faculty, 10 months ago, the Masters of International Business cohort elected me and my dear friend Sidlali to become their class representatives. Younger me would be absolutely shocked to see where I am right now and that I would voluntarily take over a leadership role. In general, I had other people believe in me more than I did in myself, like my parents. My mom is here tonight, and I just want to say thank you, Mommy. My mom is the first person to ever tell me I have what it takes to lead, and that means a lot coming from a female leader. But obviously, mothers have to say something like that. But then, peers started saying it too, and that's when I thought, you know what, why not try it? And this is something that I experienced over and over at HALT again, getting support when challenging yourself. Because, let's be honest, this year was a challenge that shaped us. We left our old lives behind to start a new chapter. And as experiencing culture shock from living in the United States has not been enough already, we've experienced so many more cultures and so many more languages on a daily basis, while also trying to make friends and finish class assignments and so many more things. What improved the situation was the support we gave each other. Because here in San Francisco, we were our community. We cheered on our classmates' successes. And walking the halls at HALT, you would always see familiar faces. However, in Boston, they had something we didn't. And that's an accurate nickname for us, the MI Babies. Because let's face it, we are the youngest, and we loved to complain about everything. But you know, we should be great leaders now, considering the fact we are the only degree that took leadership twice. Talking about classes, let's name some of the things we learned this year. We learned how to exploit one another in a fish tank simulation, how to negotiate proper boat rental prices. Thank you, Dean Ted. We learned that visionary people stand with their arms crossed against the wall, and that most importantly, we all need to put our legs up against the wall more often while doing some box breathing. Now, all jokes aside, I would never change this experience for the world. Even though we all laughed at the beginning, thinking what kind of cult-like propaganda is this growth mindset HALT DNA thing? If we allowed it to enter our lives, we grew personally and professionally. I saw many people improve this year that entered HALT on the first day, barely talking or with a fixed mindset. And now those same people don't stop talking or stay open-minded. We resolved many conflicts this year with people that handle conflict very differently from us. And most importantly, I saw that even the shyest people are great leaders when it comes to their area of expertise. In general, we made many valuable connections with people of any country, gender, sexuality, and profession. To the point that I know if I'm ever unsure about a topic or a place to visit, I have people to help me out that I feel very lucky to call my friends. For most of us, our days of avoiding the real world are finally over. We have the next challenges ahead, like job hunts and entering into the workforce. And seeing the challenges we overcame this year, I have no doubt you will master this step as well. Finally, I would like to thank my peers. You made this year special. And on behalf of the Masters of International Business, I would like to thank the HALT staff and all of our professors for this year, for helping us out, and for getting us out of our comfort zones. Finally, I wish everyone in life to keep on surprising yourself and others of what you are capable of doing. Be kind and be brave enough to be bad at something new. Thank you.
Thank you, Jessica. Please help me recognize the person voted the Professor of the Year by the Masters of International Business, Dr. Navanita Talukdar. Navanita, please stand. Esteemed members of the faculty, I hereby present to you the graduating class of the Masters of International Business. Each student will walk on stage to receive a certificate. Students graduating with distinction, as represented by the gold cord around their necks, will walk first. I request Madison Mentz to please join me at the side podium and Vivian Manning to assist in delivering certificates. We ready?
Jessica Krenz. Linnea Abrahamson. Sorry, that's too far. Kiara Naima Atigechi. Marco Bernardi. Natalia Cardona. Bian Chao Kika. Davide Garafa. Carlo Gheorghi. Gheorghi. Lokesh Gaud. Leonardo Lecci. Lara Marcial Valdez. Guro Maria Matison. Karina Noch. Ricardo Perez. Tobias Promager. Imade Ari Krishna Sochaya. Paul Tiange. Joao Maia Tristão. Tim Van Lovren. Don Vedmans. Venance. Carla Sabina Wittler. Sarah Abu Hamdan. Mansour Al Huri. Zain Asif. Mari Omotosho.
I forget to pronounce your name, man.
Marte Maria Borger Setalid. Alison Chantel Brown. Pietro Ciccini. Francesca Barros. Woo! Gurkan Dhaliwal. Len Julian Aladdin Forge. Julian Holchen. Borja Huarte. Islam Jabarov. Samyak Jain. Bandit Galpreet. Shrikant Khanna. Ritesh Karnam. Jayesh Kayal. Jeet Purvesh Kocha. Alexandros Koutsiopias. Martin Kwaroot. Sitali Mayeganya. Angel Martin. Hugo Robert. Ni Nguyen. Maya Aimon Olivier Jackson. Rima Prativ Panchal. Ria Patel. Ben Polly. Saida Safiolina. Jose Lorenzo Suso Meliano. Swapnir Tirpude. Theoderic Chayadi. Thought I was missing another person.
All right. Our next program is the Masters of Business Analytics. Please join me in welcoming class speaker Maria Lopez.
Thank you. Dear managers, teachers, staff, colleagues, family, and friends, good afternoon. A year ago, we made one of the most important decisions that changed our lives forever. We traveled thousands of miles or kilometers away from our homes to face a new challenge. And today, we can say that we can achieve the goal. From different corners of the world, we have the opportunity to share two classrooms, full of amazing people. During the process, we learned not just about confidence intervals, data, and tons of statistics. We became pirates while learning R. We created a game that represented us and even learned about Game of Thrones with Python. Learned an astounding way to communicate and share our results with Tableau. And redesigned how we organize our ideas and our data with SQL. But especially, we learn from new cultures, languages, and life experiences. We left our comfort zone and went the extra mile to overcome each challenge we encountered along the way. First, I want to thank the whole staff, and especially each of the faculty who shared with us this experience. I cannot name you all, but I want to recognize a few of you. Kari, Navanita, Omar, Thomas, Chase, Priyanka, Luis, and Larry. All of you inspired us every day to improve ourselves. Today, thanks to you, we can say that we have developed a new portfolio of skills that will help us in our personal and professional lives. Thank you. This experience reinforced the vision that I have that family is one of the biggest engines in life. So today, I want to take a special moment to thank our families. Being far from home is not easy at all. And even in the distance, they found a way to support us and make today possible. In my case, and I'm sorry with the ones that doesn't speak Spanish, I want to dedicate these lines to mine. Desde que tengo memoria, ustedes me han enseñado que no solo debo soñar muy alto, sino que para lograrlo debo dar lo mejor de mí y un poco más. Hoy veo atrás y no puedo creer cuán lejos he llegado. Por eso quiero agradecerles a ustedes, mi familia, a mis abuelos, mis tíos y mis primos, pero especialmente a mi motor y mi inspiración más grande, papi, mami y mis bebés, cada uno de mis 5 hermanos. No hay un sueño que no hayan apoyado y, en definitiva, ustedes creen más en mí que yo misma. Hoy, más que un logro individual, celebro todo el amor y el esfuerzo que nos trajo hasta aquí. Agradezco la dicha de tenerlos y saber que donde quiera que esté, mi corazón jamás estará solo. Pues a pesar de los kilómetros, no hubo un segundo en el que ustedes me hicieran sentir lejos de casa. El agradecimiento más grande es a ustedes. Los amo. As you just noticed. As you just noticed, I'm a bit of a romantic, and I must admit that for me at least, the best part of this experience was you, the people. EMBAN will never be the same without you. The ones that are sitting here, and even those that for one reason or another are not here today. It doesn't matter if we were first year or dual degrees. We found a way to support each other every day. Inside and outside the classroom, San Francisco managed to become a home for each of us. In those who are sitting next to you, we were able to find a new family, full of completely different traditions, sayings, weird words in completely different languages, meals, parties, teamwork, and moments that we will share forever and we care in our hearts. May today also be the day to celebrate the blessing of having each other. Well, I assure you that after this, those who are sitting next to you and the ones that took a part of your heart, they will keep it forever. I hope the future brings you success and that all your dreams come true. No matter your plans, always remember how valuable you are and how far you can go when you put your mind into it. However, what I wish you the most is happiness. Wherever you are in the world, regardless your professional position, let what you are doing fill your heart and be faithful to your values, to your dreams, and those things that make you unique. I can assure you, the person that started this master a year ago is a completely different one from the one that we are today, in a profound and a good sense, of course. Remember that home is wherever you leave a piece of your heart. So I expect you to take care of those friendships you build here. Because at the end of the day, life is about collecting moments with the ones that help us to be better every day. Congratulations, Master of Science in Business Analytics. We made it.
Thank you, Maria. Two professors to recognize now. Please help me to recognize the person voted the Professor of the Year by the first year MBANs, Dr. Omar Romero Hernandez. And please recognize with me the Professor of the Year voted by the dual degree MBANs, Thomas Kernicki. esteemed members of the faculty. This is should be getting routine by now, right? Esteemed members of the faculty, I hereby present to you the graduating class of Masters of Business of Analytics. Each student will walk on stage and receive a certificate. Students graduating with distinction, as represented by the gold cords worn around their necks, will walk first. I request Tracy Fitzgerald to please join me at the side podium and Rachel Boyce to help me deliver certificates. Students, once you receive your certificates, please return directly to your seats. All right? Let's do it.
Maria Paula Lopez Moreno. Marilyn Conadu Aduchwam. Prasoon Banerjee. Felix Bulk. Maria Belen Flecha Karoska. Alvaro Flores Roente. Monica Milagros Huaita Durant. Vinny Kumar Jagamachetti. Kanak Kokil. Arjun Manohar. Ramiro Ricardo Mac Acuna. Mohammed Al Khatib. Jose Miguel Tommy Ropero. Nivedita Venkatramanan. Linda Webb. Brenda Acheng Odueso. Vivian Aditza OJ. Alexandra Harriera Edo Benavente. Raquel Alvarenga. Era Urrutia. Ayula Awe. Peter Bernardus Cromenhook. Shlok Mahendra Burke. Diksha Chandra. Tsuying Chen. Muhammad Bello Dahiru. Abhinav Dhaka. Lorenzo Donati. Pavira Duraisami. Yeah. Farouk. Caitlin Brianna Garcia. Rajesh Gurram. Nyla John. Tarek Sami Kadamani. Si Kong Lee. Luis Fernando Mendez Galdames. Timothy Neyman. Juan Ignacio Ochoa. Benedicta Arezzo Aru. It's not even close. Radhika Padsala. Chirag Parak. Vignesh Ramesh. Gracial Viven Romero. Pranay Reddy Gangareddy. Janina Ray Garcia. Ingrid Rivera Castillo. Stefano Silva Saldarriaga. Yiping Su. Surab Suresh Tarodika. Madhuri Thackeray. Siddharth Varada. Vera Thota. Joseph Sarahi Vilasis Racines. Amber Yan Wang. Sadakmal Yosinov.
All right, this year we have a few students of Masters of International Marketing and Masters of Finance graduating here in San Francisco. Esteemed members of the faculty, I hereby present to you the graduating students with a Masters of International Marketing and a Masters in Finance. Tracy and Rachel will assist. Great.
Diana Rosero. Sriharsha Chimbili.
All right. Our final program is the Masters of Disruptive Innovation. Join me in welcoming class speaker Nia Hilson.
Thank you, Dean Ted, for the introduction, and good afternoon to all of you. My name is Nia Imani Hilson, and I am a proud alumni of the, I am a proud member of the Hult alumni community. I'm here today representing the 2022 Masters of Disruption Innovation graduates. I am with you today celebrating an achievement that at one time I thought may not come. See, I believe in fate, and fate brought us here today. We all took various paths to get to this point, some more challenging than others, but all of them brought us to this moment right here. In preparing this speech for you all, I came across a quote from the former mayor of New York and also Gotham City, Ed Koch, that excited me, and I'd like to share it with you all today. He said, "The fireworks begin today. The diploma is a lighted match, and each of you is the fuse." Now, we, the Masters of Disruptive Innovation graduates, chose a program that would help us to keep moving against the current, to make the world a better place despite longstanding legacy, and to make changes so big and beautiful, the world is forced to sit back and watch. Our degree just might be the most Hultian of them all, as it is the degree that encourages us to do. With that being said, I encourage all of us to do with purpose. Don't change things just because you can, but use those tools instilled in us here to make a change for good. All around the world, governments and economies are facing unprecedented times. We're recovering from a global pandemic, while another medical concern is on the rise. War is causing international famine. Global warming is finally affecting our everyday lives, and so many other opportunities for change are currently staring at us in the face. This degree was made for now, and the few of us with the privilege to possess it are the superheroes rising to the occasion. Yeah, we are. We looked into the face of a global pandemic and we said, so what? There began our training montage detailing 2 years of hard work, dedication, and maybe even a little bit of fun. It features struggles with visa offices, coordinated travel, socially distanced classrooms, and overly worked webcams, all while covering most of our faces with a mask. Consider today the start of your mission. No matter the size of that mission, we're sure to succeed with the tools awarded to us with this degree. Now, no hero has ever saved the world on their own. We all have a team supporting us, so please bear with me for one more moment while I thank them while I have the chance. First, I have to say, to all the graduates of 2022, thank you for inspiring me every day by being an example of amazing students and people. Thank you to the faculty and staff who have shared with us their time and attention. We really appreciate it. Thank you to all of the friends and family who have supported us throughout our entire lifetimes. Thank you to my special California family who's been taking care of me while I've been here. And thank you to my little brother, Gabriel. Thank you for being a reason I keep going. I hope that one day I'm an example of success for you to be proud of. Most importantly, to my mom. I know it's very cliche to say that without you I wouldn't be here, but let's face it, it's true. So thank you for bringing me into the world. Thank you for valuing your education and encouraging me to value mine. Thank you for answering my calls through tears and excitement. Thank you for showing up today, even though I might have asked you not to. And most importantly, thank you for giving me a choice and always supporting me. I love you. Dean Ted, we're ready for those certificates now.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, Nia. That was a very clear instruction. Please also help me recognize the person that MDI has voted as Faculty of the Year, Dr. Robert Barlow. He is not able to join us today, so I will convey your applause to him. Esteemed members of the faculty, I hereby present to you the graduating class of Master of Disruptive Innovation. Each student will walk on stage and receive a certificate. Students graduating with distinction, as represented by the gold cords worn around their necks, will walk first. I request Madison Mentz to please join me at the side podium, and Rachel Boyce to help me deliver certificates.
Nia Imani Hilson. Scarlett Stella Bernardis Mayer. Natithorn Chanpressert. Christophe Jérôme Arjuna Petepermal. Ben Reitzek. Fatima Abubakar Kundiri. Nitara Duthi. Jules Lamenz. Henny Guesso. Pamela Liutiama, Pamela. Mariah Ebony Marshall. Mawala Onig, oh my God. Onig Banjo. Oh my God. Where'd you go? Isha Barta, would you write down? Bartra, sorry. Oh, she wrote it down. Okay.
We have one last surprise before I make the final pronouncements. And to the members of the staff, I'm calling an audible on this one. Quick change. I would like four students to join me on the stage, two and two. From the MBA program, I would like Katarina Jurich to come up here. I'd like Carolina Mazur to come up here. I would like from the MBAM program, Linda Webb to come up here. And from the MIB program, I would like Ricardo Perez to come up here. Could those four students please come up to the stage? They don't know what's happening right now. Perfect. Perfect. Over here, Linda. Perfect. I am delighted to announce a new global award that begins with the class of 2022 and will continue in perpetuity, the Hodges Scholar Award. Dr. Stephen Hodges served as the founding president of HALT International Business School for 16 years, from 2006 to 2022. During his tenure, HALT became a global leader in business education with campuses across three continents, over 4,000 annual graduates, and a network of over 30,000 alumni. Under his leadership, HALT became the first triple-accredited business school in the U.S. and is consistently ranked among the top business schools in the world. His entrepreneurial spirit, focus on innovation, belief in the power of practical learning, and his commitment to academic rigor epitomize the HALT ethos. In honor of his contributions, we have established the Hodges Scholar Award to graduates graduating in the top 1% of their class globally. On behalf of the HALT International Business School, It is my great pleasure to announce that from a total of 19 award recipients globally, we have 4 graduates here today who are in the inaugural group of the Hodges Scholarship. Now you understand why these people are standing next to me. Let me repeat their names. Katarina Jurek, Carolina Mazur, Ricardo Perez, and Linda Webb. Congratulations on this extraordinary academic achievement. The class of 2022 will soon be showcased on Hult's website and receive a personal letter of recognition from Hult's president, Matt Lilly. But for right now, will somebody with a camera please take a picture of me with this brain trust? Thank you. You may be seated. And now the long-awaited moment has arrived. Will the members of the faculty, staff, family, and friends please stand? Students, please stay seated. By the authority vested in me by the Academic Board of the Hult International Business School, the California Bureau of Private and Post-Secondary Education, and the Ashridge Bonar Law Memorial Trust, I am pleased to bestow upon these students the degrees of Masters of Business Administration, Masters of Science in International Business, Master of Science in Finance, Master of Science in Business Analytics, Master of Science in International Marketing, Master of Science in Disruptive Innovation. I welcome them into the society of those who practice these learned arts in the industry. To all of the students in the room and watching online, you are now graduated. Please stand, yell, cheer, clap, stomp your feet, hug your neighbor, fist bump, yell at your family. Okay. All right. Even though I now have no authority whatsoever, I'll provide you with the recommended order to depart this auditorium. I encourage all students, all family members, all staff, all faculty to meet us, to convene on the other side of this building underneath the huge dome of the Palace of Fine Arts where we can take pictures with each other. I invite the MBAN, MFIN, and MIMs to depart. Family, friends, and faculty, please stay here. MBAN, MFINs, and MIMs, you may slowly progress out the sides. Now the MIBs may depart. Masters of International Business, you may depart. All right, now MBAs, you may depart. Masters of Disruptive Innovation, you may depart. in this room. They are your children, they are your friends, and for the last year, they have become our children and our friends. Thank you for sharing them with us. You may also depart. I declare this ceremony adjourned. Faculty.